Welcome to the 1 minute apologist. 1 minute
apologist.
If you had 1 minute
apologia
to be able to unpack for the audience,
we interview the world's leading apologists to provide credible answers to curious questions.
Dr. Habermas, does the Bible always promise escape from our suffering?
Actually, I think that's fairly rare. You do find verses like that in the Bible. But for the most part, my conclusion after looking over the field of verses is the Bible generally tells us not that the victory is being taken from the suffering, but that he holds our hand through the suffering. I think the Bible teaches a from sort of thing. And I mean, for example, in John chapter 14, 15, 16, there's three very prominent promises that we love to quote. Ask whatever you want and I'll do it. Ask anything in my name, I'll do it for you. Right alongside all three of those, there's three comments that says, you're going to have issues, people are going to think they're doing God a favor when they kill you. In this world, you're going to have trouble. Mm-hmm. So the ask whatever you want and you'll get it, three of them. You're going to have issues, three of them. We memorize these, we don't pay attention to these. We ask why God's not doing this for us, and we totally ignore these. So I think generally in the context and in the whole book, John may be the book that makes the most comments about taken from. Mm-hmm. He's also the one that tells us the value of suffering. Psalms, by far, makes the most comments about delivering from, but makes far more comments about why do bad things happen to good people, good things happen to bad people, and so on. So I think we need to take them in the context. I think by and large, you're going to look a long time before you see a monolithic sort of approach in Scripture where God's always taken us from it. I just don't think that's a biblical message at all.
Thank you, Dr. Habermas.
You're welcome, Father.